capacity to change your problems into a solution. God has the capacity to get your disadvantages and they become an advantage. And with one word he said, let there be, and it was.
For the last 33 years, Dr. K.L. Dickson has been ministering good news to the people. The sick healed, the lame walk, the dead raised, people saved, and lives transformed.
Abraham saw that far. God provided him because he saw him as a God of provision. I am seeing millionaires. I am seeing aircraft owners. I am seeing people with big businesses over here. I am seeing pastors, bishops, archbishops. I am seeing extraordinary miracles in your land. Because your God is the creator of the universe.
They were
bitten by venomous snakes.
Bakatemwa enjoka ezobusegu.
And many of them died.
Baingi mulibo bafu.
And the Lord spoke to Moses.
Ukama yabaza hali Moses.
Now it is the time.
Hatkan niko kasumi.
Go and put a bronze tree in the middle of Dura.
Genda okwate omuti okuteke hagati yomkinongore kya
Dura. Bronze snake on it.
Otekeho nenjoke yomlinga.
So that whoever is bitten by a snake,
guliomu eno aratemwage njoka,
just comes and looks at this snake on the tree.
Araijaga arole burora hanjoka eno enyakule amuti.
And the venom
obusegu
will be neutralized.
Burahuamu amani.
Now, listen to this.
Kuliriza kinu.
You had to be in a visibility
where
you are viewing this bronze snake on the tree. And the moment you would look at it, you would be healed of the venom. Now, the Bible says, so shall be the Son of God. When he will be hanged on the tree, and whoever shall look at him, the venom of sin, the venom of sickness, the venom of poverty, the venom of failure, the venom of any trouble, shall be neutralized. And today, don't look at me. Look at Jesus Christ. And do you know what he's saying today? It is finished. Can you say it is finished?
It is finished.
I don't hear you. Can you say it is finished?
It is finished.
Are you saying it with faith?
Yeah.
How many of you know that Jesus is real? If you know Jesus, can you say amen? There are strongholds right now that are being destroyed. And there are some of you that have never been touched by the power of the Holy Spirit. I want to tell you, power is coming where you are. Power is coming where you are. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Say power. I don't hear you. Ladies, can you say power? Okay, maybe men were the problem. Men, can you say power? And everybody say, power is coming upon me today. In Jesus' name. Somebody shout hallelujah. There is a sense of freedom that you are getting. In a few minutes, you are climaxing 2014. But I want to tell you, whatever it carried for you, it is now ending in Jesus' name. Somebody shout hallelujah. Something supernatural. Something supernatural. Something supernatural. Something divine. Strongholds are being destroyed. Sicknesses are healed. Lame people are going to walk tonight. Blind people are going to see. Somebody shout hallelujah. I want you to tell somebody something supernatural. never known what we call a supernatural? It's something beyond your ability. Something that you cannot do for yourself. Something that is very hard for you to do. By the power of God, it's being done tonight in Jesus' name. I don't care what you've gone through. I don't care what the world has said about you. I don't care what wind has blown against you. I don't care which witch doctor has bewitched you. 2015 is your year. Somebody shout hallelujah. I want to tell you something. Some people say they can never be excited. But I want to tell you, there's a time when you'll be excited. Let me show you something. The supernatural being works with a lot of excitement. Every time God touches you, the joy of the Lord is manifested in your hands, in your palm, in your head, in your legs. Each one of you, everything about you is excited. Somebody shout hallelujah. And let me tell you, when strongholds come your way, they tie you and they bind you and they put you down. But not when you are set free. When you are set free, you can jump up in the space. Because the joy of the Lord is your strength. Somebody shout hallelujah. I don't care. Tell anybody, I don't care.
I don't care
what 2014 has been.
What 2014?
I don't care.
I don't care
what I've gone through.
I don't care
what has happened to me. But right now,
as I'm speaking,
the wind is over. Say, the wind is over now. Can you say, the wind is over now? I am seeing Jesus. And he's speaking to me personally. And he's saying, it is finished. It is finished. It is finished. So I am hearing him with my ears. He's speaking to me. It is finished. It is finished. I don't care what you did. It can be forgiven. It can be forgiven. Somebody shout hallelujah. You can't hold on to your past. Because holding on to your past, what are you going to do about it? Now drop the past and catch the future. Tell them, drop the past now.
Drop the past.
Say, drop the past right now.
Drop the past
and catch the future.
And catch the future.
Somebody shout hallelujah. I want you to lift up your hands and everybody say something to Jesus. Speak from the bottom of your heart. Some of you have had a very bad year. Some of you have been disturbed. Some of you have been in jail. Some of you have lost your properties. Some of you have been ridiculed. Some of you have been flogged. Whatever it is. But let me tell you something. That was not the end of the situation. That was not the end of the world. It could have marked the beginning of your breakthrough. God is on your side and is saying today, 2015 is your year. 2015 is your year. 2015 is your year. Heavenly Father, we come into your presence today. We call upon the name that is above every name. The name of Jesus. We glorify you. For you're the God of our healing. You're the God of our restoration. Say, Jesus, have mercy upon me. Forgive me from all my shortcomings. Forgive me from all my weaknesses, my wrong utterances, wrong companies, wrong associations. Every involvement of things that do not glorify you, I denounce them today in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I've gone through everywhere, but I am somewhere now. I am in your presence, and I am sorry, so very sorry. I need forgiveness, and I believe I deserve it. For you said on the cross, it is finished. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus, we thank you for this wonderful time. Because you're the greatest gift. And we're very thankful of you. In Jesus' name. Let everybody say amen. God bless you so much as you take a seat. Worship him for just a little while. You can take a seat. We'll have you back in just a little more. Let us give them a very big hand clap. Yes, we are remaining with just a few minutes to end the year 2014. You know, there are a lot of you that have had good and bad things in this year. But praise be to the name of the Lord. It is now almost over. There's a new year ahead of you. And in our program today, we are very anxious to see great things happening as we close this year. There is a time that you have to look at this scripture and forgive that there's also a time when God forgives, gets tired of looking at your sins. Let's go to the book of Isaiah and see what it speaks to us for the year 2015. Does your Bible carry Isaiah? You have the book of Isaiah? Okay, let's go to chapter 40.
Isaiah Makumiana.
Because we are almost close to the new year. 40:1-2 and 5. Do you know what he says there? Okay. Comfort, yes, comfort my people. Says your God. Speak comfort to Jerusalem. And cry out to her that her warfare is ended. Cry out to her that her warfare is ended. That her iniquities is pardoned. For she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins.
Now,
have you ever had somebody paying you for your sins? Double? It is only 2015. When the Lord will look at all your wrongs, I said, I have now turned them around and I'm paying you double for it. Now, I want you to read the scripture once again. He's not meaning to punish you double. No, he has said now he has changed his heart. He will count your sins, add them up, and pay you double. So ask your neighbor and say, did you do any sin this year? If you didn't do any, you have nothing to be paid for. You have nothing to be paid for. Let us read the scripture again. Verse 1. Somebody on the computer, please. We are on verse 1. Comfort, yes, comfort my people, says God. Comfort them.
And
speak comfort to Jerusalem and cry out to her that her warfare her warfare, her battle, her struggling, thing that has been going into, you know, her minimizing of herself is ended. Oh, why can't you say amen? Go on. That her iniquity is pardoned. Her iniquity is pardoned. Are you with me? For she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins.
Would
you imagine if somebody says, how many sins have you committed this year? Would you feel a little bit ashamed if you say, I did not commit any? Because you have nothing to be paid for. According to this scripture. But praise be to God, you lied. You talked on the phone. You told people you were in Kampala when you were in Fort Porto. You were a little bit angry sometimes. You know, a lot of things, tell them, a lot of things happened around me. But praise be to God. Now, God has told me in 2015, He's paying me double. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you know God is more than a father? At times He looks at you and says the way to condemn and judge you of everything wrong that you've done is not going to work now. Now it's time for me to forgive you and restore you. Somebody shout hallelujah. It is time for me to forgive you and restore you. That's what he's saying in 2015. That God has forgiven you and God has restored you and is paying you double for every sin that you have ever committed. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go on and see what he says. That's what he has for 2014-15 for you. In verse 5, what does he say? The glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. I don't care what you've been going through, but Jesus on the cross said, it is finished. Now, your shortcomings does not change the status Jesus is in. You are either in or out, but it remains there. So when he says, I'll pay you double for your sins, that means I will not look at the magnitude of how wrong you went. But my grace and mercy will draw you closer to me, and I'll pay you twice for everything wrong that has ever happened to you.
You know,
God, there's a time when he gets tired of punishing you, and he wants to show you his good hand. And say, despite that, I have punished for everything wrong that you did, now I have decided to ignore your shortcomings and just bless you double. Somebody shout
hallelujah
and just bless you double. Can you say amen? Say, so that is for 2015. Tell me, but that is for 2015. Now let me give you another prophetic message. In Isaiah 45, verse 1 to 3 and 5. Isaiah 45. There's another prophetic message for you for 2015. Isaiah chapter 45. Verse 1 through 3. And thereafter 5. He says, thus say the Lord to his anointed. Now, who is the anointed? Jesus Christ is the anointed. But when he saved you, you also became the anointed. Oh, you people, you don't understand me. Do we have an anointed person here? I don't hear you. Can you say amen? Now say, thus say the Lord to his anointed.
To
Silas, whose right hand I have held. To subdue nations. Before him. And lose the armor of kings. To open before him. The double doors. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Have you ever opened a double door? There are things that cannot go into a single door. Or you people wake up. This, somebody shout hallelujah. The blessings that are coming your way, I prophesy. In the name of the Lord God Almighty, they are coming in a double door. Somebody shout hallelujah. Tell your neighbor for me
that
my blessing, in 2012 are so big that it will require opening a double door. Somebody shout hallelujah. Say, the car I am getting is going to be so big that a single garage door cannot let that car that in. It will be a double door. Somebody, can you prophesy? Don't sleep on me. Prophesy. Aburugana, nyoni nja kwera gula, yinyo manuta kwera gula obiyanyo. Yinyo na aleluya. Gama ntitunge eriange. Eri omwake kumibili kumine etano. Nirikenda kwetagi senji jibiri. Somebody shout hallelujah. 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 Sit down for a moment and hear this. This is what it says. We are entering this year in prophecy. Tell him I'm entering this year in style. You are prophesying in Jesus' name. You are speaking victory. Thus says to the Lord, to his anointed, to Silas, whose right hand I have held, to subdue nations before him, and lose the armor of kings, to open before him the double doors. Tell
him
about double. I'm afraid 2015 ladies are going to deliver double. Let me tell you something. 2014, problems were everywhere. Everywhere you put a leg, there is a problem. You go back and there is a problem. There is a radio, a problem on the radio. The newspaper have a problem. Somebody shout hallelujah. 2015, everywhere you step, there is a miracle. Somebody shout hallelujah. Double. The people that are paying you, double. These ones are calling you, these ones are sending you a check, this one has said, double. Oh, somebody shout hallelujah. Listen to this. To open before him the double doors so that the gates will not be shut. In the morning, the gates are open. In the afternoon, the container is arriving. In the evening, the plane is landing. Somebody shout hallelujah. Double. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let's go to verse 2 and see what it says. Verse 2. The one on the computer is also getting double. I will go before you. Oh, come on. I know. Tell your neighbor, I know you. You are a coward. I know you are a coward. And he knows you're a coward. But you know what he's saying? I will go before you and make the crooked places straight. Somebody shout hallelujah. I'll break in pieces the gates of bronze and cut the bars of iron for your own sake. Somebody shout hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, don't sit comfortably on that chair. Something must happen in your hands. Something must happen somewhere. There's something supernatural going on. Somebody shout hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, there is excitement in the house of the Lord. When you're before Jesus, be excited. Shake the shackles around you. Break them down. Move around a little bit. Because something somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. I will go before you and make the crooked places straight. And I break in the pieces. Come on. I break into pieces. Look, the shackles that have been tying you. The strongholds, everything that have been hindering you, I break it into pieces. The gates of bronze and cut the bars of iron. Listen to this. Say, tell them about 2015. I am marching into my miracle. Say 2015. I am marching into my miracles. Double. Listen to verse 3. Listen to verse 3. I'll give you. Come on. This one makes me collapse over here. I'll give you the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of the sacred places, that you may know that I, the Lord, who call you by your name, I am the God of Israel. Listen to this. You're entering already in 2015, but you're entering with a miracle. You're entering with power. Somebody shout hallelujah! Listen to what he says. And I'll give you. You will give me treasures of darkness. Do you know what the word darkness means? Things that I separated, I put them so deep, hid them from everybody else, and saved them for only you. Oh hallelujah. Listen to this. Things that you separated. Say, things that you separated. Hid them in the deep dark place for nobody else but me. Somebody shout hallelujah. He says, I'll give you the treasures of darkness and the hidden riches of secret. There's a secret in your garden today. There's a secret in your heel today. There's a secret in your background today. There's a secret in your backyard. There's something supernatural. Somewhere, God himself has been hiding it there. You are going to see it. Somebody shout hallelujah. Listen to this. That you may know that I, the Lord, who call you by your name, I am the God of Israel. Omurutoro. Nagamanti obero nzanisa obero tarukumanya obero tekeleza tinyine shinyina betwati ningenda kukuhi tungo eriserekerwe.
eryeshirima kandi ngenda kukikonyetegereze omanyire kimu nti nyoruhanga nyakwezi ibara lyawe niyoruhanga wa Isirayeli. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Verse 5. What does he say? Verse 5. I am the Lord. I am the Lord. And there is no other. There is no God beside me. I'll guard you. Though you have not known me.
God says
it is,
but now he wants to show you who he is, and you would understand that he is a God that is able.
2015 is a year of victory. Regardless of what, I have already stepped in my miracle. Somebody shout hallelujah. Regardless of nothing, I already stepped my miracle. I am already in 2015. I am already there. Say, I am already there. I am already in a miracle. I am, somebody shout hallelujah. Say, I am already there. I am already there. I am already there. God has promised me. I am there. I will not die. I will see the goodness of the Lord. 2015 is my year. 2015 is me. Everybody talk to the Lord. Talk to the Lord.
God.
God. Yes, God. God.
What is a man?
Yes, let us give the Lord a very big hand clap. You can take a seat for a little while. I have a special announcement. We are already 10 minutes into 2015. Well, shout unto the Lord. Hallelujah! Yeah. Listen to this. When they left Egypt, they were only crying for one thing, that we may get into the wilderness and we give God an offering. Tell me about the only reason why they were crying to leave and go into Egypt is that they may meet somewhere in the wilderness and give God an offering. The first thing that you have to do after you worship God in the new area is to give Him an offering. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What did you give God not to die in 2014? What did you give God not to be in the hospital right now? What did you give God that now you are among the people that God has promised that 2015 is a year of prosperity? Somebody shout hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus.
Listen to this. It's a time to worship Him with all your strength, with all your power. It's a time to look into everything that you have and sow a seed in the new year. Let me show you in Psalms as we come to that. Psalms 45. Psalm 65, rather. Verse 1 and 2. This is what he says. I'm speaking a prophetic word into your new year. Psalm 65, verse 1 and 2. Are you there? He says, praise is awaiting you, O God, in Zion. And to you, the vow shall be performed. Now ask your neighbor, do you have a vow? Have you promised God something? Do you know what? Many times what do we do? If God give me what you promised me, well, God has promised you long enough. But now, a vow has got to be performed to the God of your creation. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go on, verse 2. Oh, you who hear prayer, to you all flesh will come. Now, in verse 11 and 12, it says this, 11 and 12. 11 and 12. You crown the year with your goodness. Now, David is speaking to God. You crown the year with your goodness. And your path drip with abundance. You know what dripping? It's like it is so wholesome that it is just dripping. This year is dripping with abundance. Oh, somebody shout hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, this year for me is dripping with abundance. Verse 12. They drop on pastures of the wilderness, and the little hills rejoice on every side. Now you people are going to go to your field, and every tree in 2015 will be bending because it is overweighted with fruit. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
coffee overweight, matoke overweight, I mean business overweight, your transport overweight, shillings, money overweight. Somebody shout hallelujah. People love money, but 2015 you will count money and get tired and say let's go to bed, we'll count tomorrow. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Now, a vow is what you promised God. And every time we see victory, that's why we turn to God for thanksgiving. Do you still remember the promises for 2015? Have you forgotten them already? Listen to this. This is God speaking to you. He's asking you how many sins. And I pay you double. You may think he's a spy. He's spying on me today. So I want to pay you double. Are you sure you want to pay me double? You try, give me two. And he gives you four. Now you begin even to lie about yourself. Because you need more payment. That is exactly what your God has said. Now listen to this. We don't want to waste any time. Because the first thing we are going to do, I don't want any of you to leave. We want to put a seal of the oil over your forehead, that this prophecy, when it was delivered, you were here. Let me tell you something. It doesn't matter who has been bewitching you. All his witchcraft has been dampened by the power of God. Somebody shout hallelujah. Do you know there are people that said that you are not going to succeed? Do you know such a people? They've been counting your days. Now they better count their days. Somebody shout hallelujah! Do you know how they team up and they say, this time you are going nowhere, this time you are going everywhere? Somebody shout hallelujah! Somebody shout hallelujah! And church, you must learn to understand that seeds rejuvenate your miracle. It is like your harvest is rejuvenated by your seeds. You cannot just sit there and wait for God to give you. You have to sow seeds and sow big seeds, because you speak your blessings over the seed and the Lord turns them around, and instead of giving you 100%, he gives you 1,000%. That's what he's deciding to do. When you look at a poor man, giving him dinner is not enough. You also give him shoes. But while he's putting on the shoes, you realize he doesn't have socks. You give him 5 pairs of socks. While he's putting on pairs of socks, you realize he doesn't have a pant. You give him 5 pants. While he's putting on the pant, you realize he has not brushed his teeth. You give him some detergent. While he's brushing the teeth, you realize the hair is not combed. You give him a comb. While he has all of this, he tells you he doesn't have nowhere to sleep. You take him in the room. While he's there, no blanket. You give him a blanket. God is going to bless you that way. That he's going to look at your west, your east, your south, your north, your everywhere. And he will bless you in everywhere imaginable. Somebody shout hallelujah. But you know what's going to be your responsibility? It's every time to come to God with tears. And sow in the morning. Say, sow in the morning. Sow in the afternoon. Sow in the evening. Sow all the time. Because the more you sow, the more he will give you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Now, the time is coming when sin will lose market in you. When God gives you grace, you have no time to sin. When God gives you grace, sin loses market in your brain. Because all you have to do is to worship God in the truth and the spirit. Somebody shout hallelujah. And you grow from grace to grace, from faith to faith, from glory to glory, from power to power, from victory to victory, from one step to another. People will do everything possible, but you just keep going up and going up and going up. And people ask you, what is going on? And you tell them, when the Lord is on my side, I am more than a conqueror. Let me tell you something. The time is now. 2015 is your appointed time. 2015 is your time. Is the time to see things that you've been anticipating to see. 2015, this century, this cathedral is coming up. You are going to see it. And many of you, if not all of you, none is going to die until it is finished. I mean, God is going to bless you with a nice church, bless you with a good pastor, bless you with a nice car, bless you with a good worship team, bless you with a good city, bless you. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Everything that you're going to see will be blessed, a blessing. You know, there's a time when you go home to sleep in your bed and it will be a blessing. Sleep in your bed and it's sweet. But this time you could not sleep. You wake up in the middle of the night and you do like this. This time you will sleep. Tea will be good for you. You will like milk. You will be healthy. Because the Lord your God is on your side. Can somebody say amen? God has the capacity to change your problems into a solution. God has the capacity to get your disadvantages and they become an advantage. And with one word he said, let there be, and it was.
For the last 33 years, Dr. K.L. Dickson has been ministering good news to the people. The sick healed, the lame walk, the dead raised, people saved, and lives transformed.
Abraham saw that far. God provided him because he saw him as a God of provision. I am seeing millionaires. I am seeing aircraft owners. I am seeing people with big businesses over here. I am seeing pastors, bishops, archbishops. I am seeing extraordinary miracles in your land. Because your God is the creator of the universe.